Hi, and welcome back to our open stop-motion film project. I'm sorry for the delay, but everything broke down as soon as I started. I wanted to start. Then the Wirecast, as you can see in the over there, the Wirecast is... It's the video mixer, so it broke down, and certainly it couldn't remember anything. So I had to reinstall it. But now it seems to be running smooth, I think. But let us try. It has been a while since I have made new episode because of a lot of different things. First of all, the monitor over here burned out and I had to get a new one on that. And the monitor inside the workshop, those didn't work, so I had to get a new one in there. Because when I go in there, I cannot see what I'm doing, so I cannot see what you can see, and therefore it's not possible to do it right. So, but I get it fixed, and first of all, I got two new cameras, and now the mics are put on the camera on inside, so you cannot hear me when I'm showing. I can put audio on this one too. Then you should be able to hear me. And I got a new camera in there because I have a smaller one before. I have the Vixen, I think it called overseas, Vixen cameras, or Vixia, I think they are called. And I got two of those, so now the picture quality in there is much better than it was before. You know, a lot of the things I make are very small details, and when you do those small details, you have to have a really good picture to see it. And then I had a problem with my printer. I had to change the extruder in it because this one was burned out, so I got a new one. In that one too. So, and I have been printed since, but I'm not printing tonight, so and then I had to make stuff around in the studio too, because I have to. I'm reached that point where I have to start building the landscape on the table, so I can figure out the sizes and everything. So. And the last thing I think you saw I was doing was the head, and somebody have maybe wondered why I make them this big, because the figures are not that big. But the reason is that when I print them out in the size they I want them to be in, I need to have them make the small details on them so they get really good. And if I cannot make them if I make them this small in the clay, it don't work really. It's very hard to make that small details in clay. So it's easier to make them big, and because the when you scan them, I use the 1-2-3D scan. I take pictures all around, from the side, and all around from the top. I take maybe 20 pictures this way around, and then I take 20 pictures around from the top, and then I load them up to 1-2-3D scan, and I get a 3D rendering out, so I can print them in the printer. So, and after a little work on them, they look like this. Oh, the right hand to the right side. So, these are not total finished yet, but these are more or less. And then I make a cast. I make a mold of this, and then I make a cast, and then I the cast is a silicone cast, and then I have wires in the fingers so I can bend them so he can get a grip. And the hands are pretty much the same for all the figures in the story, so I have to make them a little different size, but apart from that, they are more or less the same, all of them. And you saw I have a big foot, the size of that too, in clay. And then I print them out, and this is pretty much how they look when I print them out. A little rough on the edges, but when I have sanded them and prepared them, then I can get a pretty detailed mold out. And the reason I spread the toes is so I can, when I make a cast, I can when I make a mold, I can make a cast where I can move the toes and put them together again. So I can animate, but. And one more thing you didn't see, I want to get for you. Move this away. You also saw me working on that one, and that's how it ended up being. It's very dusty now because it stood a long time, but you can see, and this is only the first layer paint, so we have to paint this some more times so we get the right color. But it was just so I could see how it would end up look like. But that is printed out, but you can see I cannot print that big a tree in the printer at once, so I cut it like this here, and it's three pieces glued together, and then get this. So, and I have printed 4 of those out. But, and you know, I have made a lot of, put this down here. I have made a lot of these. And they started out like this. You know, you have seen me make, those of you who have followed along have seen me made a lot of these here, and also a top and a lower part, and then I put a stick between and glue another one on top, and then I have this. I want to put one more branch on, but this was just so I could see how it ended up looking. But it looks pretty much like a tree. But these trees, oops, it already fall apart. I have to glue it on better. But that's how I will go and get something to glue with. So, and by the way, the glue gun also went bad, so I had to get a new one of those too. So there is a lot of stuff all the time that can go wrong, and if it can go wrong, it will go wrong, like tonight when I started here. We can get it to stick this time. You know, it's all about patience. And sometimes I don't have enough of it. But I have made, what do I have? Something between 50 and 100 trees I have made. But we need a lot to a forest. And but a good thing is that I had found another way to mark the object, the models, because if you remember, I put small crosses on them to give it a, to make a good scan, but I found another way, much, much quicker. So now the tree is fine again. See, like plants in the living room. So, and I'll show you how, if I can get this out of the contacts. My mouse I made, and then I tried to put a little fur on him after I printed him. It's very rough, but I think you can see him. He looks a little like a little mouse, shady, but you can see I had just sprinkled him. I took a stiff brush and then I just put it in paint. I'll show you. I took a brush like this you use to do nails, and then I dipped it in paint, this one, and then I just scratched over it so it sprayed on it, and I got some really nice scan out of it, because all the sprays are different in size, so somehow it recognized it, so I don't have to sit and do all of these crosses anymore, because they take a crazy amount of time. So I put this one back on. And I made a little beaver too. So I have to make nice work a little on before it gets like I want them, like the hands and the feet. It's very difficult to print them so they get just right in the first run. But tonight we will make, we need some more trees of more character like this, so not all trees are look more or less the same. So I'll make a two-trunk tree. See how that will gonna look. But I will put a couple of sticks in it, in them first. So I will just get two sticks in here. Get a little hold on them. I'm sorry for all this running around but all my preparation went away when it broke down. I was really happy. I was had good had good time to prepare in advance, and then everything went bad anyway. So that's how it goes. But I hope I will get better at it over time. So that sounds so we don't get any feedback return. It's just so that we get a little stiffness in it. Maybe they are a little too high. We can always take stuff off again. Shorten them down. it looked like rabbit ears on a television set. All my presets went away when I restarted and reloaded and reinstalled the Wirecast. I guess it's because this setup is maxed out, crazy maxed out. Even the computer that is running this is an i7. But I cannot put more cameras on it. But I have, right now I have four, normally I have five. But and the cameras are connecting to what are they called? Black magic cards, and there are three of the cameras are connecting to a three black magic card in the computer, and then the bigger but older camera I have out here on the printer. I have no light out there now, but it's a firewire. I would like to have a couple of more cameras on, but then I need a bigger computer, but it's hard to make a bigger one than that. the one I have, so I don't know. Then the next step is a TriCaster, but they are expensive. All of what we are doing here are cheap in old TV convention terms, but expensive in my pocket money terms. So every camera I put up, it cost $1,500. And then the cameras and the lenses to take the pictures to the movie. I have a 5D Canon 5D Mark II. So, and they're kind of expensive too. So I have already put a lot of money in this. And the life are expensive. Everything is expensive. But we forget all about that. When you are doing what you love, then it don't matter. Other people are spending crazy amount of money on cars and whatnot, so I I think we can have a little one, some yellow clay here. Tomorrow we will be printing. Well, I didn't have the time to set it up today. So I have a lot of birds I have modeled that I need to scan and print. So printing, and there will be a lot of modeling yet. Before we are finished, as long as we get a little longer every day, then it's good enough. Tomorrow. And tomorrow, my grandson Frederick will come and play Minecraft in the kids' workshop. And while he are doing that, I will prepare to make a Minecraft wolf. My grandson is 9 years old, and all kids in that age are playing Minecraft, so he is loving that too. And of course we are, his comments are in Danish because he cannot speak English yet, but even that he corrects me all the time. You don't think my pronunciation are good enough, so I will try to learn. Children and grandchildren can be hard critics. Very hard. But we love them anyway. Meat on the man. And yesterday I was making the granddaughter. I have a granddaughter that is 6 years old, and together with her I'm making a doll castle. Those of you who have small kids, you can follow along on pixelfantasy.com, where or the YouTube channel, kids. And build a little or a big castle to your little girls in your life. Not because it's cheaper, but because you have a great time together. Like a father-son project, father-daughter project, or something like that, or mother. Project. and I try to keep it simple so everybody can participate. You don't need a lot of fancy tools or anything. Saw and some glue and a good spirit. And the trees I'm making here, I will not make mold of. I will just print them out, and maybe some I will not even print out or print. I will like the big one. I don't know if you can see it from here. No, it's too far back. But all of the things I will make close up on are of course much bigger than the background. Where I will make the kind of panorama pictures. See when we get to it. How we will cheat. So we can get it to look like it's a big world. Kind of important. And we have spring here now. It's great. So if I can in the weekend, I will take a couple of hours off and get out and take some pictures. Outland inspiration. Soon we have Easter, and then I will take a little vacation in a summer cottage. Together with my grandchildren. Parents, I think I have barely been outside the studio this winter. Only to go to the grocery store or something like that. See, you don't have to put much inside. You get it steady enough to work on. Some branches on afterwards. Starting to be a little soft when you transfer your heat from your hands to the clay. And if anyone wonders, this is a oil-based clay. It never get stiff. It never hardened. I can keep on reusing it. But when you spraying paint on it, then you have to remove that before you do, before you reuse it. But so you lose a little all the time, but not much. To get some wire so I can make some branches, because this is too thin. usually smoothen it with oil after I'm finished, but today I have forgotten my oil in the car. I have been repairing car. New bearings on the 1-point wheel. When you're using all your money on this, then you have to drive an old car. So that's how that goes. And then you have to repair it yourself. They are a little soft. I will get some wire. Of a little heavier kind. Coffee is cold. Coffee is cold. Push it a little. Okay. If we do like this. And then we turn it around. This twist it. I'll take something else to twist. This, I think we can. Shall we try? It's see if we destroy it all or what. We didn't. That was nifty. Nothing tried, nothing gained. So and then we can even do like this. Isn't that right? Maybe more like this. I'll get another class to so. It's hard to you to see against that monitor over there. I'm always speculating in how I can do this more you friendly, but the only way is when I make videos, and then I have to use a lot of time on making those, so that's why I'm streaming live. Editing videos take a lot of time if you want to do it right. So it's a little. And that time goes from what I'm doing here . So this is more for the most creative nerds out there, I think. And the only other way was if there was a lot of people here helping me, so we could switch between. Between them and what they were doing, but there are no one but me. To get, where is my tools? I can find them here. I don't know about you, but I spent a lot of time looking for stuff. I don't know where I put. There it was. Put in the wrong door. A lot of fiddling around. to it's a little more cold. Cooler. That one. When the parts gets too small, then if the heat are too high, it gets too soft. Sorry. Very cold coffee. Okay, it's stuck. I'm afraid of breaking the plate. I think we need a little more, or do we? No. Give it a little more. That's why you cannot make a lot of, if you give the trees, or those trees you give a lot of characters, you cannot duplicate them too much in the forest, because then it's recognizable that it's the same tree all around. But if you make them more conform, or more the same, then you can uniform, was the word I was looking for, then you can duplicate like that one. You just have to twist them a little, then nobody aware that there are 25 of the same type. And especially not if you mix them with some of these more different ones. This and then we take our amazing machine. I think I can hear raindrops outside. But it's okay if it just rains in the night and the sun is shining in the day. And we have had sunshine here all day. For several days now, so spring is here. Maybe I was a little too wild with this one. Okay. Less could have done it. But, see here. It is in real 3D. At least on the my side of the camera. I got an offer from the cable provider. They could give me $300 down and $60 up. I have $60 up now, but I don't know if that will help me. And the packets I have now, I can mix blend myself so I can have 60 up and 60 down, or I can blend it so I have what I like up or what I like down. And I have a little weak frame rate. If I move the hand a little fast, you can see it. I don't know if that's a computer or it's the upload. I don't think so, because not many servers will take more than 60 plus if you send it. But over time I want to make make use of Skype to talk to some interesting people who have made some good stop motion animations and so on. Kind of interview or to hear a little about what they think of things. Learn something from other animators around the world. And there are some pretty amazing people out there making unbelievable good stuff. Advantage of that is that I can use Skype, I can use another computer to take that from. You will see. No limit to what I would like to do. Sometimes there is a limit to what's possible. Hiccups. Stop it. That was better. I have to take in account that I cannot, when I use a branch like this, then I have to have level difference between them. So I get a tight canopy. Because you have to, in this state, also think about the lighting. And if you want this, what's the, when you are in the forest, you one of the one of the feeling, or one of the, what are we calling it? It's the colored light that goes through the leaves. That's a big part of what we come up with a word for it. Perception of the forest. Oops. Nails in the fingernails. Forest kind of closes around you. That's that also the part of it. Do the last fine tuning when of the branches when I get hold of some oil. There's not much left in the pot. then we try to take it a little more easy this time. And then we have one more branch. Push the tripod with the camera on. One day I will make so all the cameras come down from the ceiling. Peace. The problem with me that is I forget the camera and then I block it with my arms and whatnot. Hair in the soup. And I also have to remember to mention that sometimes people don't seem to be able to figure out when I'm live and when I'm not, and when what, how this is working. I am. I will take the little one here. Fantasy on my own site, pixelfantasies.com. There is a schedule, and every day in the week, Monday to Friday, I am on from 8 p.m. to 12 p.m. And that's the live portion, and that's, what is it, it's UTC plus one. And on Wednesdays we have a kids workshop from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. And on Fridays we have kids workshop at 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. As Wednesdays 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. and Friday 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. And but open stop motion film project, that's every evening my time, and that's UTC plus one, 8 p.m. to 12 p.m. So that is 4 hours, and after that I upload the video, because what we are doing now, I am recording, and then when we are finished here, 12 o'clock my time, then I upload the video, the recorded video of it, and then I send that until I'm on again the next day, 8 p.m. But when I have to get the right mouse, when I'm not on, like when it's the recorded version of this I send, then I, if you see up in the left corner, I write pre-recorded, so you can see I'm not necessarily here by the computer. So, and that's why I'm not answering in the chat. Sometimes people don't read that up there, but I write it up there when it's rebroadcasted. Then, but the reason YouTube write it's live, it is because I'm streaming from here all the time, 24/7, because they are not these 4 hours videos, they are not saving those. So, and then it always also have that advantage that people from in another time zone can see it too. So when I'm finished here at 12 o'clock, they are awakening in Japan and so on. And so I, that way I get around all the way. So when I'm not answering the chat, I'm not because I don't want, it's because I don't sit here and see it. And if you have a question you ask in the chat, of course I will answer it, but sometimes people just want to tell me I'm an idiot, so I, of course, not answering that. I'm just blocking you. So I don't have time for that nonsense. Nobody have to see this. They don't pay anything to see this, so there's a lot of stuff on YouTube, so it's just carry on to the next. If they find this not worth looking at, I guarantee you there is something for everyone on YouTube. Honest question, and well, I always answer them. And that's the reason I have the chat open, because I want to interact with people. That's why I sent it in the first place. That is much more fun that way. And I know what I'm doing is not a typical YouTube thing, so, but the reason I am on YouTube, that's the only way I can save it to my channel or embed it on my own site. before YouTube, I was on Justin and had a lot of nice people. To have fun with, but one day they just closed the door, and then, and even us who was paying customers, we were not warned in advance. They just said goodbye. And you couldn't even say goodbye to all your friends or anything. They just closed, got their money and disappeared. And that's why I have my own site, so. And I will prefer if those who are interested in this connect to that site, because that site will not, that domain is mine and will not just disappear one day. Those of us who have been on the net in a long time, we have seen this, that a lot, where some network just disappear or close down, and you have put a lot of work into it, and then they just close, sell it and close. This way, disappointing. That's how it works. So that's why I always tell everybody to get their own site, even if they don't have a lot of traffic. It don't matter. You have your own home on the net, and that's very important. If you are making content of any kind, tech stuff or whatever, those social networks that are crazy popular today, they can be gone tomorrow. I don't expect YouTube or Google to be, but you never know. When you are as old as me, you have seen a lot of things come and go, even big stuff you never would think would die, but sometimes they do. big Google ban, and I hope they will exist in many years. But I'm also realistic. Take my precautions. Maybe that was a little too much. How do we do that? How long is it? Tall, I think. All right. Thank you. This up a bit. A notch. You cannot have that the upper branches are thicker than the lower ones. At least a little natural. That's a good thing with clay, that you can keep on doing it until you get it right. Every other material you kind of lost if you do it wrong. Maybe that's why we also love computers so much, because we can always keep on doing it there until we get it right. You have many chances. Before, when you made a drawing, if you the last final drawing, if you did it wrong, example, if you did it with airbrush or something like that, then you was really screwed with you. once took a plate like this with colors on and home with my father was when I was an apprentice who said at his place he was just gotten finished with a big airbrush. It had taken 14 days to make. And I don't remember what I should do on it, but I should do something. And then I took the platter with the paint, and that's water solute paint, and I took it too quick, so the paint stayed in the air a little while before it dropped down on the airbrush. That was not good. He just turned pale, but he didn't explode. That was funny, because he usually did if I have squeezed that toothpaste too wrong or parked my shoes wrong or whatever. The smallest things could get him really fired up, but he didn't say anything. That time. Maybe he was so so shocked he couldn't. At least I was. That was not good. But I promise I did not do it on purpose. My God, I would have given anything for that paint to have been staying in the air so I could get the played under it again, but it didn't. It didn't. I think we all have made that type of catastrophically mistakes. Once or twice in our life. Then I clicked on this. I moved the mouse. Office is not the thing we need right now. No, we will, yes, we will. And we'll do it this way. Nip this one here. Wait for that. It's hard with your neck and shoulder muscles to sit with your hands up here all the time. But of course I could stand up. Stand up a little. I have been on my feet all day. It's nice to have a little sitting time. the recording has gone well. Because you never know. It can go really bad. Sometimes when it starts like it did today, before it's over, and then it's too late. So if I rebroadcast the old one, then it's because this one went wrong. But there are no indication that that should be the case. So that is this another here. That's a black hair. That very mysterious. My son just wrote that sometimes it's not fun to be adult. Especially not when the toilet is clogged. It's much easier when that responsibility belongs to your father. Yep. Have fun. That's the only thing I can say. Thank you, Marcus. I am making a stop motion movie. And making the object, in this case the trees, I have to put in it, and I have made a lot of those. Maybe 100 trees or so, but I need a lot of different trees because the story goes on in the Stone Age, and it's a story about a young boy and his friend and their family, and they are living in the woods. So I have to make a lot of trees. Before I'm finished, and then when this is oil-based clay, and when I'm finished with that, not so much the tree, then this one is printed, at least the half of it, and I can show you. I scan them. And then I glue them together with a stick in between, so they get a little bit higher, because they have to have a certain size. If they don't, I have to make the figures that's so small that it's very difficult to make them detailed. So I make them in certain size, but I have a very big tree. All the stuff I'm going to make close up on, I make very big, and but you can see here is a hand, but the one I sculpt first was as big as my hand, and then I 3D printed, and then I have printed out in this size, and this size fits to the figure that I'm gonna crawl in a big tree, and then I have to make them even smaller. But the smaller they are, the lesser details I get, so that's why I have to make them in different sizes. And when I have this of these, his foot here, or hands, or body, or whatever, head, or so, I make a mold up, and then I make a cast in silicone, and then I put wires in the silicone so I can animate the fingers and the hands and so on, and I put more skeleton-like thing inside his body, so I can bend knees and so he can walk with his foot and so on. So it looks naturally, but there is a long way before I get to that. But thank you for asking. But now we are getting to the end of today, even that we have been delayed a little because of the computer crash, but I will hope I'll see some of you or all of you again tomorrow. And tomorrow, if everything goes as planned, we are on 8 p.m. my time. And what was it? +1 UTC. So. You have to figure out yourself how it fits your time schedule or your time zone, must it be. So I will say thank you, and I will start wrong mouse again, and we will carry on again tomorrow. And thanks for tonight, and thanks for watching. Goodbye.